Hi, my name is Jojo and I have been living in a tent in Sweden for 2 years. And in this video I would like to answer the question if this was actually legal. But please don't take my words as legally binding. If you want to be sure, I would always recommend to check back with your local municipality if you plan to do something like this. In Sweden, as in most other countries, I guess, you need to have an address where you live. In my case, I had some friends who were living close by the lake where I could store some of my stuff and also set up my computer to edit the videos there. In Sweden, as I guess in most other Northern European countries, we have something that is called the right of public access. It allows you basically to roam around freely and enjoy nature, as long as you don't disturb or destroy. It allows you to access any land, except someone's garden or cultivated areas, put up a tent anywhere, pick berries, mushrooms and flowers, swim in lakes, and some other more. Setting up a tent means for 1 or 2 nights. If you want to camp longer anywhere, you need to have the permission of the landowner, which I did in my case. I asked and got the permission. Thank you very much for this. And so I spent my year on the island, thinking everything was okay. Until I learned about the Swedish Coastal Protection Law, literally on the last day on the island, before I moved to the raft. What is the Swedish Coastal Protection Law? This law is meant to protect the shore 100 meters in the water and 100 to 300 meters in land. And since people like to build houses on shores, it could end up like it is in Austria, for example, that the shores are cluttered with private houses and you don't have much natural coastline left, and you have a hard time accessing the lake and even have to pay for that sometime. I'm talking to you, Wolfgang See. So this law, for example, restricts permanent buildings on shores. And living for 1 year on an island is kind of a permanent thing. So I have to admit that my year on the island was not in accordance to the Swedish Coastal Protection Law. So you could probably say, well, it's easier to ask for forgiveness than for permission, but that's not quite the goal of a law like this. There are still quite a few nice places like here in Sweden all around the world, and I think it's good that we protect them and don't leave any traces, don't destroy nor disturb. So what's the solution? You can set up your tent further away. Or if you prefer the water, you can get a houseboat or build a raft. If you live somewhere for a longer period of time, in any case, you need a proper sewage solution. And for shorter stays, I can recommend this book, How to Shit in the Woods. Thou shalt have a place also without the camp, where thou shalt go forth abroad. And thou shalt have a paddle upon thy weapon, and it shall be, when thou shalt east thyself abroad, thou shalt dig therewith, and thou shalt turn back and cover that which cometh from thee. Leaving no traces at all out in nature, I don't really think that this is possible, but I think it's a good goal when you try to keep them as minimal as possible.